Sometimes I get enough of having to listen to Nathan Oakley, Quantum Eraser, Widget Gets It, 10th Man and the like in order to make my videos. So I decided to look at Quantum Eraser's website, globeterminator.com. I saw the same old nonsense there in the childish layout with the silly emojis and the stupid pubescent insults, but at least I wouldn't have to listen to the irritating voice of this self-proclaimed genius. He posted 7 of what he calls his flat earth proofs. In a series of 7 videos, I will pulverize each and every one of them. This is part 7, No Vacuum of Space. When a flurfer says there is no vacuum of space, what he really means is what all of the other flurfers repeat ad nauseum: you can't have gas pressure next to a vacuum, so space is fake. This, of course, is a straw man. No glober claims there is gas pressure next to a vacuum of space. First, there is, how do you have a gas pressure, atmospheric pressure without a container? Mistake number 1. Gas pressure and atmospheric pressure have different definitions and should not be used as if they are interchangeable. The link QE provides states that pressure is a force exerted by the substance per unit area on another substance. This part he conveniently ignores as usual. He emphasizes the walls of the container part. And of course, he totally ignores the definition of atmospheric pressure, that is, the force per unit area exerted by an atmospheric column, that is, the entire body of air above the specified area. No mention of a container at all, only a unit area. He carefully avoids defining what he considers to be a container. He must avoid defining it because blue marble science has demonstrated that you can have gas pressure in an open pipe. When confronted with that demonstration, all of a sudden, all of QE's acolytes started saying that an open pipe also is a container. But that argument has been destroyed by QE himself. You can't have gas pressure in an open system, and if the container is not sealed, the gas will escape. Quantum Eraser loves his law of contradiction, but he is a victim of that law at every turn he takes. Then he comes up with the infamous second law of thermodynamics. Mistake number 2. The second law of thermodynamics states that the state of entropy of the entire universe as an isolated system will always increase over time. The fact that most flurfers don't know what entropy means isn't the worst part. It is the fact that they consistently ignore the part where it says that the second law deals with the entire universe as an isolated system. And QE proves all by himself that the Earth isn't even a closed system, but should be considered an open system. The second law of thermodynamics doesn't apply to the Earth. And with that, he has destroyed the entire straw man that is set up by him and others. No need to mention that the citation he uses from Arthur S. Eddington, The Nature of the Physical World, 1913, page 74, is not to be found on page 74, it's on page 37. But hey, it's Quantum Eraser, the king of the faulty citations. Then he opens the entire Pandora box of silly arguments about the container being the necessary antecedent. Mistake number 3. When are flurfers going to find out the difference between an antecedent and a prerequisite? And even then, it wouldn't be true. Volume needs a container. Mistake number 4. A cubic meter doesn't exist without a physical box of 1 meter by 1 meter by 1 meter. Or does it? Without the walls of a container, you can't have gas pressure. Mistake number 5. There is no atmospheric pressure in the middle of the box, only alongside its walls. Or is there? And other assorted nonsense. Basically, Fluffers deny the existence of the vacuum of space, period. Because you can't have gas pressure next to a vacuum, so space is fake. Mistake number 6. No one claims there is gas pressure next to a vacuum of space. But it is much worse. With his famous Mage experiment, Mr. Sensible has demonstrated that at 38,706 meter altitude, the atmospheric pressure has decreased to 251 pascals, that's slightly less than 2 torr. So high up in the sky, the atmospheric pressure has decreased with more than 101,000 pascal. If the argument of gas pressure needing a container, otherwise the gas would expand infinitely, were true, quod non, how can a pressure difference of 101,000 pascal exist, or 758 torr? And to top it off, this is a measured pressure at that altitude. It exists, even when the Earth were flat, quod non. And the pressure at 38 kilometers is in line with the barometric formula. At 71 kilometers, the atmospheric pressure is as low as 3.69 pascal, that is 0.028 torr, so very near vacuum. When a Fluffer says space doesn't exist because you can't have gas pressure next to a vacuum, he must be wrong, because if he were right, you couldn't live on a flat Earth either. How stupid can anyone be? Oh well, it's just Quantum Eraser, who definitely has deserved his nickname, Questionable Education.